Hi, welcome back to my channel. My name's Eva. I make videos all about sustainable living, low waste living, minimalism, veganism, whatever you want me to make videos on, I will make them for you. And today I'm going to be talking about the 10 low waste trends or things that I do not consume as a low waste being, because I either have alternatives that I do myself or I don't think that that's sustainable. So let's get straight into it. I have a list on my computer, apologies if I keep turning. But so the first one is wax wraps. So as a vegan, I obviously wouldn't get beeswax wraps, I would get soy wax wraps, but you do have to re-wax them, which I think is super time consuming, costs money, is kind of unsustainable when there are other ways that you can go about these things. You can store your food instead of putting a wrap over a bowl, just, you know, put a plate over it, or you could just put like a hanky over it. Or you could just put it in like an old takeaway box or a little plastic lunch box or a glass lunch box or a metal lunch, whatever you use. You could store it like that. I have lots of these kind of bandanas that I got from a vintage store years and years and years ago. And I absolutely love them. They're really great. I always carry one around with me because if I get peckish, I tend to eat fruit and bread. And if I go to a bakery, I can just, or even a supermarket, I can just wrap the bread in here. It's really big, so it's fine to wrap food in, and I find it works fine. Just eat the food in it within a day and it doesn't go stale. But yeah, you don't need to spend all your money on wax wraps. And the next one is like these silicone stasher bags that everyone seems to be talking about, and these like sandwich bags. I would just use a lunchbox or use one of these. But alternatively, I understand that if you're like going on a day hike and you don't want to carry a big lunchbox or whatever, you would want a sandwich bag or something to put your snacks in. So that's why I make these. It's a Sainsbury's bag with material around the outside. I just sewed it together. I'm only in like a basic sewer, so I can't do anything fancy, but these are really, really good. If you would like to see videos about me making these sort of products, please comment down below and I can always make them for you, show you how to make them yourselves and how to be more sustainable and whatnot. So yeah, these are really great. And then when I put the food in, I just like fold it over, and I can also wash these in the washing machine, which is great. So they're always nice and clean. I've had this one for about a year and a bit now, you know, little home DIY. Okay, and then the next one is new jars. You do not need to go out and buy new matching jars. Just use the jars you already have. If you really want matching ones, just buy the same pasta sauce over and over again like I do. I buy the same sauce, the same size jar, the same shop every week. I just really like their bolognese sauce for my baked beans. And if not, go around charity shops. There's no need to buy new glass. Glass is made from raw materials from the earth, has to be mined, and then it's turned into glass. Although glass is really widely recycled, especially in Europe, about 70% of glass is recycled, which is great, but try and always buy secondhand. That's your first place to go when you're looking for something, you know? Okay, and the next one is the guppy bag, or the guppy friend. It's about £20-25, and it's a really tightly sewn nylon bag that you put your synthetic fibers in and put them in a wash machine. I use a pillowcase and I just wrap a hairband around the top of the pillowcase so it doesn't open up when it's in the wash, and that works absolutely fine for me. I don't see the point in spending that much money, and I want to try and make low waste as accessible for people as possible. And I did make a whole video about laundry and stuff that I can link down below for you. And yeah, so no guppy friend for me. The next one is produce bags. I do not buy produce bags. I make produce bags. So these are all made from Lucy and Yak bags because I love Lucy and Yak, although I'm trying not to buy anything new this year. Well, trying to cut down on my Lucy and Yak consumption. You can make them from anything. I made them from my dad's shirts. This is old t-shirt, works really well. You don't need to buy produce bags. Unless you're buying things like beans or lentils, I don't see why you can't just like put them in your bag and not put them in a produce bag. Like a lot of things don't need to, I understand for like weighing and stuff, but you know, there are alternatives. You don't need to go out, especially please don't buy the Sainsbury's ones. It really annoys me that they've done that. I think it's greenwashing. I can make a whole video on that if you want to see it. Please comment down below. But yes, please try and make things yourself and do things yourself before buying them, because they're expensive. And if you do want to buy produce bags, buy them from someone like me. I don't sell them currently. It just seems like a lot of work. But try and buy them from someone locally who makes them from discarded materials that wouldn't otherwise be used and would just go into the recycling centre. And yeah, instead of buying new materials, because new materials are not good for the planet. Okay, next is bamboo toothbrush. I was using bamboo toothbrushes for years. And also like toothpaste, like you can get really expensive kind of like vegan in a jar toothpastes. But as an alternative to that, I've always made my own tooth powder. I've been using this now for about 2 years. I love it. It's cheap, easy. It works well. Before that, I was making my own toothpaste, but it just took up a bit too much space when I went traveling. So I now use a fully recyclable electric toothbrush head. Me and my boyfriend share an electric toothbrush. He's had it for years. I decided to join the bandwagon because I was fed up of throwing away my bamboo toothbrushes because the bristles would just go bleh after like no time at all. Probably my own fault for brushing too hard. This is a good way to protect my teeth from overbrushing. So yeah, I have jumped off of that trend. They're also like £4 a toothbrush. It's crazy. Next one is straws. People give me straws for like Christmas. I think they think I'll use them. I don't really use them. I'll use them if we ever get any like orange juice or anything like that, because I just don't want loads of sugar all over my teeth all the time. But other than that, no. Although I must say that reusable straws are really great for people that do need to use a straw in order to assist them with their drinking, which is great. But a lot of us bought into the reusable straw trend and we never really used straws before, and we just use them because we're like, oh, I got my metal straw. And that's what I did at first as well, but like now I've kind of realized that it was just a trend and I don't actually really like using straws. And yeah, I can just drink from a glass with my mouth. Okay, next one is silicone baking mats. These seem really popular at the moment and I don't really get it. I don't have any silicone baking things or even like cupcake holders. I have one of those like metal dishes which has cupcake holders that I nicked from my parents when I moved out. They are two. I'm the only one that bakes. So I just put butter on the pan. Like if I am baking something other in the oven even, I just put my fingers literally, because I don't use like kitchen roll or anything. I put my fingers in my butter and then I just like rub it on the baking tray that I'm using, or you know, the whatever I'm using, I just dip my finger in the butter and I rub it on there. There's literally nothing else to it. Sorry, my phone's on my battery. And that works absolutely fine for me. So, you know, I don't see the need to buy into these trends. And also silicone is plastic. So yeah. And then the last one, which I get really passionate about, is dishcloths. There are so many brands. I use a dish brush, which I bought from my local DIY store. It's like this big and it cost me like £2, which is great. It's not one of those big handle ones. It's just a little one. But in terms of dishcloths, there's so many different companies out there that make all these really expensive dishcloths that are this, that, and the other. But they just wear away so quickly and I've heard so many bad things about them that I wouldn't really want to buy one just because of that. Instead, I literally use these. I picked up a bunch of flannels or like face cloths from a secondhand store for like 50p for two. And I mean, they're not even like, they're in a state. But I mean, we use them all the time. So we have about five different ones that we rotate between and put them in a washing machine whenever we do a wash or whatever. And this is one of them. This one's, you know, been folded up, sitting in the drawer. These work fine and it doesn't, it's a bit rough now, but at the end of the day, I really don't care. Like, I'm washing my dishes. I just want my dishes to be clean. I don't care about, you know, how pretty my cloth looks when I clean it. But yeah, this is just a really cheap alternative to that. So I really hope you enjoyed this video. I'm sorry it's so long. Please give it a thumbs up if you did. Please comment down below if you want to see any other videos related to the things I've talked about in this video. And let me know any of the low waist swap trends that you don't buy into. It'd be really interesting to hear what you make and what you do yourself to replace items that others may buy. And yeah, look out for the next video, or whether it's uploaded before or after this, I'm not sure, of the trends that I do buy into and the things that I really do enjoy buying. And yeah, please subscribe if you haven't already, and I hope to see you in the next one. Bye.